We got this far. Can you feel the love tonight, tonight? How it's laid to rest.
The Music Medics program started all with an event that Gene Cockcroft put forth for us, going to a children's hospital one time. And that was a wonderful thing. It was the entire chorus. But I remember at that point in time, I thought that it would really be important for us to get small ensembles like a quartet to go in and sing to kids that couldn't even come to that playroom.
What's better than doing something you love to do and being able to give back to the community at the same time? It's like it's a win-win for everybody.
Personally, it's probably the most fulfilling thing that I do at all in my life. It is a chance to just give to the kids that really need what we are giving to them. They need a break from the monotony of being in the hospital environment. They need people who are bringing friendship and hope and music to them.
I spent 2 months in this very hospital. I came down with a syndrome called Guillain-Barré syndrome, which crippled me. I was paralyzed. I spent about a month in this very building, actually. And the best thing in life was to have some of my friends and barbershop brothers come in and visit me. So when I learned about the Music Medic program, it was a no-brainer for me. I had to do it.
So we have a pool of tenors, basses, baritones, and leads who we pull from. So we always get together a little bit ahead of time.
We're going to follow you. Matter, right from Matter. No matter.
And warm up, and often that's the first time that the four of us have sung together like it was today. That's a really important opportunity for us to get together and figure out each other's timing. You never know quite what to expect with the four guys, and you have to work some things out. But we always take it very lightly because we get to make music together. We get to make music for the kids.
The whole key, nice job. No pun intended, is the one right before the key change.
What we've seen today is really what the majority of these events are like. There are happy occasions. The kid ends up smiling and clapping and all that stuff. But we've sung to some children where you know that that's the last song that they're probably ever going to hear in their life. Those are the ones you carry with you. The children's hospitals are wonderful. First of all, they have a department called the Child Life Department that handles that child's entertainment. So if you want to start this up in your hometown, approach the children's hospital, approach your local children's hospital, tell them you want to speak to the Child Life Department.
They're going to think, oh my God, what are these people going to do to our lives around here, messing up the daily routine? And that's a normal thing. But once they get to know you and they know that you're going to stay out of their way, make sure that they're able to do the job they're paid to do, and they're just going to bring some life and love into the room, that's all there is to it. I mean, you make the relationships first.
It brightens up the whole room, the patient's room, the nurse's station, the hallways, just everybody starts inquiring and asking, so who are you guys? This is amazing, and that you volunteer your time and do all this, it's so wonderful. We're so very grateful and lucky to have them.
I was like, what is that? I was like, is that the television? Or is that like a group of people singing? And I opened the door and I saw this group of men that were dressed in scrubs singing. And at first I thought maybe they were doctors, but they're not doctors. This is what they do. This is their volunteering. This is their contribution to help children feel better in the hospital. And I was just like almost in tears about it. I know for me, it's coming to a hospital to visit anybody is not, it's not easy. And when it's a child, it's much more challenging. God forbid you don't have people around you, your family members or friends or people that would come to a hospital to visit you, or God forbid your sick child, that to know that there are people in the community that want to be part of someone's healing, you're really not alone. People care.
I tell other people about it. I tell my chorus brothers, you know, you really ought to do this because it's an indescribable feeling.
What an incredible program. What a great opportunity. And I wouldn't miss these visits for the world.
They don't expect to see four guys in scrubs show up and suddenly start singing.
But I'll tell you what, every time I walk into one of these hospitals, I'm reminded of Gene Cockcroft. And I know that he would be proud that this program was going on.
Did you like that? Oh, good.
Thank you.
I'm
so glad. Thank you for allowing us to see you.
Thanks for listening. You have a pretty smile. All right.